What's cooking, Knights fans? We're here in the soccer offices for another moment with Masucci. We're here with Marco Masucci, the head coach of the women's soccer team. We had two games to report on. First was a 5-0 win against Delaware State. Another one was a 2-1 loss to an undefeated Ryder team. What do you think that your young team takes more from?
Definitely the Sunday game against Ryder. That was a game that we had. I think we had them against the ropes for the first 35 minutes of the game. Another time that we should have been able to put them away. Weren't able to play 90 minutes, made a couple of changes, the pace of the game really dropped, and it took us way too long before we got back into it. Finally finding a tying goal with 5 minutes left in the game. Too many emotions, lack of concentration, and we gave up the go-ahead goal again with 2 minutes to go. So I think it was just the biggest issue right now is game management. They got to learn how to manage the moments of the game and be able to properly, play depending on the different situations that are presented in front of them.
Anytime your team can put together 5 goals in one game, you have to be happy with that. We know Rachel Hoekstra, we've been talking about her, I feel like every week she's been putting some goals together. But how good is it to see some of the other players get some goals? How much do you think that'll help the offense?
The 5-0 win was good for, just getting the first win out of the way. I think that confidence carried into Sunday's game as well, so I definitely saw a difference in the way we were attacking. But there's differences game to game. Just because we do it once does not mean it's going to happen again. And we found ourselves in a similar situation on Sunday as we were in the previous weeks, where it comes down to, missing some scoring chances and not being able to put the team away when we have the chance to do it. So it's a growing process. It's going to take a few weeks before this gets, until we're consistent enough.
In that Delaware State game, it was good to see Lindsay Williams, Aaron Kearns, and Casey Schiavone get a goal. How much do you think that'll help them moving forward?
No, it's great. I think Lindsay she's generated a lot of chances this season for us. She missed a few, a couple against Air Force. She missed one against Hartford. I know she was getting very frustrated. We worked with her. We just basically told her that, the goal was going to come. Finally getting a goal was a big moment for her. Aaron scoring her first ever goal at FDU in college career, I think that was a big special moment for her as well, off a set piece, so we like those. And Casey, Casey's going to be a big player for us this year, and she's been battling injury a little bit, but she scored a great free kick, and hopefully that gets her going.
And then defensively, you started a lot of freshmen back there. Sometimes you'd even start four at a time. To get the shutout and then to give up 2 goals to Ryder, how would you assess how your defense has been playing?
It's the trend with the back line has been the same since the beginning of the season. We're not giving up many shots. We're not giving up many clear-cut chances on goal. Goals have been circumstantial. We've given up goals off second balls that haven't been cleared properly. We've given up goals off a loss of possession in our own third. These are freshman concentration type of errors. For 89 out of the 90 minutes, I think we're flawless. Then, just one lapse gives them the goal that they need to either tie a game or go up, against us. So it's been a little bit frustrating, but, I can't complain at all. The team's been playing very organized soccer up to now.
Well, Coach, thank you for your time this week, and we look forward to hopefully a win against Lafayette. And until next time, thanks for tuning in.